5 years on, the spirit of Frankie, dancer Paul Rutherford, is embarking on a new career. Only this time round, he's at centre stage.
I want your love. I want your love.
I'm much more comfortable with, I don't have to speak for other people anymore. I'm much more relaxed about it. I'm not so... I just kicked back a little bit, you know, 5 foot behind at your place there. I sort of didn't sort of impose on that. I was quite happy to do that. I realised now that I was frustrated. It was Holly on voice, Mark on bass and Paul on legs, wasn't it?
Paul's increasing frustration had been matched by the growing public outrage at Frankie's antics. Soon life began to imitate art, and the band's laddish image started to overtake the boys themselves.
I think it was a bit of pain by the end. You know what I mean? I think that's part of the reason why we weren't doing a lot of things, because everyone was like a bit scared. Like these monsters had come flying in, you know what I mean, and just disrupt everything.
The band's launch had been accompanied by an unusually large amount of hype, including the Frankie Says t-shirts and the pseudo-intellectual sloganeering of their record company. This aspect of the image building also began to backfire.
A lot of it was false, because it didn't work in the end, you know what I mean? It was all this highbrow stuff that no one really understood. And basically, the only reason that we sold records was because people happened to like Holly's voice and they fancied Mark, you know what I mean? We ended up a teen band.
In response to accusations of not being able to play, the band recorded the rock-oriented album Liverpool. This, however, only served to highlight divisions within the band. The inevitable split followed soon after.
Well, I was actually very, very relieved, because I found it hard to get out of bed in the end, because I was like, I really can't be bothered doing this now. You know, I mean, there was no incentive at all. It was, what's going to happen today? Are we going to have another argument?
Now, Paul's put the Frankie era behind him, and in collaboration with Sheffield band ABC, has recorded fresh material. But despite the acrimonious breakup, he has few regrets about his involvement with Frankie.
I think we played the game. I think everyone plays the game when it happens. You suddenly, like, let's phone Berryhurst and have tabs completely on call. Let's do this, let's do that, you know what I mean? Let's fly first class around the world, wherever it is, you know? And it's just like, it's silly in there, because you don't need it. You just think you need things like that. I suppose it's good to go through it once. I wouldn't trade it for the world.
I want your love. I need your love. Just like the sun.